Hi, I'm Father Simon Lau. When I recall the life in the seminary, I still remember how the fathers of the seminary, the formators, they observe our character. Very often, they observe us when we are playing game, football, volleyball. Because during the game times, we do not pretend ourselves because we are so into it. Unlike other times, we can pretend ourselves and cover up ourselves. Another time will be eating time, especially when we come to durian season. The College General, the seminary in Penang, has many durian trees. Whenever we come to durian season, we will have a lot of durian, and we are allowed to eat the durians 2 days a week. However, not all the durians are good. There are some very good and some so-so only. So when we eat the durian, everybody will go for the good one. If you are not fast enough, you will finish first and you will not get any good durian. Try to think when each time you eat durian with your friends, are you go for the good one first? Especially if there are Musang King there. Would you go for the Musang King first? We all know how to choose the best for ourselves. Whenever we taste the best, we will never forget. And we will go back to the best. That's why the Musang King is so expensive, because everybody go for that. Psalm 34:10 told us that taste and see that the Lord is good. Do we taste the goodness and the greatness of God? And the goodness and greatness of God is beyond comparison. There is nothing in this world can compare to the goodness of God. If we really taste God as we taste the Musang King, we will never go to other things because nothing can replace God's goodness. Recently, because of the MCO, all of us are not able to come to church. And for many, they are already used to the way that we are having now for online masses. And even I start hearing some comment saying that it is so convenient that now we are attending Mass online. And even some ask me, can we continue to have this even after the MCO? Because they said, it is so convenient. Yes, it is very convenient. For those especially got children, every Sunday, you do not need to come to church anymore now. You do not need to wake up earlier and prepare your children, and your Sunday can have more free time. So what do you think? So what is your choice if these are given to you? Brothers and sisters, if we forget what is Eucharist all about, that means we never really taste the goodness of God. And all the while, we are really no idea about our faith. When the Israelites was exiled to Babylon, the people were taken away from Jerusalem to Babylon. They were separated from the temple, and many lose their faith because many of them, their faith were not rooted. After 70 years of exile, many of them already settled down in Babylon, and the Persian allowed them to go back to Jerusalem to rebuild the temple. There were people did not willing to go back to Jerusalem because they already have a good life in Babylon. Psalm 136 said, if I forget you, Jerusalem, let my right hand withered. Oh, let my tongue cleave to my mouth if I remember you not. If I prize not Jerusalem above all my joys. We can easily forget who we are. Perhaps it is because we do not know who we are all this while. And it is important for us to reflect on this since we are reopening our church in these few weeks. There are many people eagerly waiting to come back for the worship. But on the other hand, there are people hesitate because of different reasons. In today's gospel, Jesus said, anyone who prefers father or mother to me is not worthy of me. And anyone who prefers son or daughter to me is not worthy of me. Also, he said, anyone who does not take his cross and follow in my footsteps is not worthy of me. On this passage, Jesus did not ask us to neglect our parents, nor our children neither. What he was trying to say is how we prioritize our life and what kind of foundation we build our life onto. Jesus tells us to build our foundation on solid rock and not on sandy ground. Jesus wants us to put him as our foundation. He wants us to make him as our priority in life. He also said, we cannot serve two masters. Either you hate one and love the other. We have to clear about our direction. Instead, Jesus never asked us to neglect our parents, but he wants us to be able to detach from people, from relationship, from things, especially the material world. Sometimes we are so attached to one relationship and it causes us not able to see what God wants us to be. And it also not able to see the potential in life. Sometimes parents cannot let go their children, even though their children already grown out. Parents are still intervening into their marriage life. Or the other way, you are so attached to your parents, which you are not able to live independently and freely. God doesn't want to take things from us. He doesn't need our things. He wants us to put him as priority is for our good. He wants us to trust in him, have faith in him is for our good. There is nothing greater than him. Just think of it. If we put God as our priority in life, everything in our life will change. Our way of thinking, our values, our direction of life, everything changed. And he will drive us to the life of fullness. The problem here is most of us not able to make that step, not able to take a risk and not able to try something new. Just as some very reluctant to try durian because they don't like the smell. Sometimes smell may not be good. Just as God's way is not our way. Very often, our logic is not God's logic. God's logic looks not nice, sound unacceptable. For instance, in today's gospel, Jesus said, anyone who finds his life will lose it. And anyone who loses his life for my sake will find it. This is not our logic. It doesn't sound good. Most of the people do not want to die. Other example, if you want to be the greatest, learn to be the smallest. When you have nothing, you have everything. When you are become weak, you will be strong. The world tells us we shouldn't be the weak. And many of us do not want people to see us weak. We want to be strong. However, this is not God's way. God shows us God's greatest power and love is through the weakest body of Christ on the cross. And he said, take up our own cross and follow his footsteps. It doesn't sound good and look good, but that is the best way and the only way. And he said, get in through the narrow gate. And this narrow gate, many do not want to go. So, brothers and sisters, today is a call for reprioritize your life to Christ. Are you building your life on this rock? Or are you holding or attached to many other things? My friends, the more you hold on, the more you want to control, the more you attach, the more you will suffer from them. May God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.